In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Terry died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Let us now proceed in song. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Terry, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd,
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Julie, on behalf of Holy Family Parish, I'd like to present you with this handmade prayer shawl. Lots of time and tears and prayers have gone into that by our prayer shawl ministry. So whenever you hold on to that prayer shawl, just know that as you continue to mourn for your husband, that we are keeping you in prayer and we're mourning with you. So welcome, everyone. My name is Father Nate Edquist. I'm the pastor here at Holy Family Parish. For those of you who may be coming in from out of town or haven't been here in a while, our three churches in La Porte have combined into one parish. We still use our three sites, but we're officially called Holy Family Parish with St. Joseph, St. Peter, and Sacred Heart. So a special welcome to all of you. It's my understanding that some of you may not be Catholic, and for some of you who may be Catholic, maybe you're not used to seeing a church like this. So Julie had mentioned to me, could you please explain to everybody why the statues are covered? Okay. Maybe you didn't know that that's what was behind me up here. This is something that even if you're not Catholic, most Catholics do not know why we cover our statues, but it relates to what we're here for. Because what we're here for is to accompany our brother Terry on his journey to eternal life. Right, we know that this is not the end. For those of us who call ourselves Christians, we know that this is not the end. We look forward to something that is much better after we move forth from this first life into the life to come. that God has promised to us for eternity. And as you have spent the last 40 years with Terry, Julie, it's just a blink in God's eye. Because God looks at the eternity of things. We look at a very small amount of time and we make a big deal out of small things that happen. But God looks at the eternal landscape of our life. So back to the question, why do we cover our statues? Why is Jesus covered up on the crucifix? Why are St. John and the Blessed Mother covered? Why is Mary and Joseph covered? Why is the Pietà covered? Okay. In the church, the last 2 weeks of Lent, we have a practice of covering sacred images and especially our statues. We are venturing upon this final finish line of Lent when we celebrate the Triduum, which is Holy Thursday, Good Friday, Holy Saturday, and Easter Sunday. This is the holiest week of the year. That's why this week in the church we call it, guess what, Holy Week. Because it's the most important time that we celebrate because of what Jesus did for us. And even though we can't see much up on that cross, we know that what Jesus did for us is he became human like us, died for us, and went all the way to that cross, suffered for you and me, and did what you and I all will do, and did what Terry did. And that is experience the reality of human death. That's what we remember this week. So we cover our statues because we're supposed to see our statues, right? That's what we come to church to see. It's up there. So why do we cover them? Well, it's to give us a notion of the stark reality that we're venturing into this week. When there's a Good Friday, meaning Jesus goes to the cross, it's utter sadness. We take a downward slope, but it's contrasted by the gladness that comes from that sadness. That Jesus is going to rise from the dead, conquer death, conquer whatever it is in you and me that is not of God, so that we could be brought closer to God. And so we cover our statues as a way to show us that this isn't the way it's always going to be. Our statues are veiled, right? What does a bride wear when she goes to her wedding day? She has a veil, and traditionally it was always over her face. So that when the groom would lift it up, the veil would be lifted, and he can finally see her face. See, ah, now I know who it is truly. That's symbolic of our Christian life, where we know that in this life, the veil is over our face, so to speak. We can't see God as he truly is while we're walking this earth. The only way that we're going to see God as he truly is when we pass through this life into the next, and then the veil gets lifted. Now we can see God for as he truly is. So this week, we cover our statues to show that this isn't how it's supposed to be. They're supposed to be taken off. We're supposed to be able to see these sacred images in their glory. Because it shows that we're supposed to see God as he is in his glory. Just like where we're at right now, this isn't the end. This isn't how it's supposed to be. This is not how it's supposed to be. But when God removes that veil and welcomes us into eternity, then we can see God face to face. So all the sadness that encompasses our world, and I don't need to go through the litany of all the crazy things that happen in our life. Not just stuff out there, but stuff in here. All of us have pretty dysfunctional hearts from time to time. We do things we know we're not supposed to do. What do we call that? The three-letter word, sin. And that puts a further veil between us and God. But we trust that when we pass from this life like Terry has, that veil is going to be lifted up and we can see God as he truly is, not covered up by all the wackiness of this world, not covered up by the slime of our sins, and not covered up by the hopelessness and despair that we so often have. This is not how it's supposed to be. God has something so much better in store. And so then when we celebrate after this week, after Jesus goes to the cross and the absolute horror of Good Friday, when he rises from the dead, we remove the veils from the statues as a way to show that, we're back to where it's supposed to be. The Lord has risen, and he's given you and me a promise of rising again too, just as he gave that promise to Terry. That's why we cover our statues, to show us that there's something so much better awaiting us, and our hearts can long for that. If your heart is not longing for something more, then there's something wrong. My heart always longs for something more. I know that everything that weighs me down on a daily basis has to mean that there's got to be something better in store. And the same thing, I'm sure, is for all of you. God has something so much better in store for us. But what does he ask of us? He asks that we do our best to try to remove that veil. Whatever it is that pulls you and me away from God, we can help remove that veil to draw closer to him, so that ultimately, at the end of our life, the final veil is removed, and we can see God face to face. Let's ask God that Terry will now see him face to face in the Lord's heavenly kingdom. Amen. I invite you to please stand. Let us now bring our prayers and our petitions before our Heavenly Father.
For Terry, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother Terry, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Terry, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, giver of life and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose blood was purchased by the blood of the Lamb. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we prepare the altar.
Father, back there.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all holy church.
I invite you to please stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Terry, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Invited to kneel for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come, until you
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Terry, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. You to please stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, so shall you be. As we celebrate the Eucharist today and we come forward for communion, we invite all of our brothers and sisters who are Catholic and disposed to receive communion to come forward and receive as you normally do. For our brothers and sisters who are not Catholic or who otherwise are not able to receive today, You are invited to come forward with arms crossed to receive a blessing, or you may remain in your pew and join us in prayer and song. We await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our mortal bodies to conform with his glorified body.
Amazing grace.
I'd like to thank you all for joining us today as we lift up Terry to eternal life. Family is inviting everyone here to please join them for a luncheon immediately following Mass. It will take place at Sacred Heart Church, our activity center at 201 Bach Street, so it is about a mile across town. So again, that's Sacred Heart Church. Everyone is invited to a luncheon. Let us stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Terry may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.